2004 New England Open returned to the International in Bolton, Massachusetts, and it boasted a very strong field of amateurs and professionals. Several players had experience in either the U.S. Open at Shinnecock or the Deutsche Bank Championships. One of those players was the first-round leader, Casey Bork, playing out of Lake Winnipesaukee Golf Club. Casey fired a 6-under par 66 on the Oaks course to take a one-shot lead over Adam Decker and Jim Hallett. Defending champion Rick Karbowski carded a 2-under par 70 on the Pines course. On day two, Karbowski got comfortable on the Oaks, quickly birdieing three of the first four holes as he cruised to a 5-under par 67, putting him at 7-under for the tournament. First-round leader Casey Bork shot a disappointing 75 on the Pines, dropping him back to 3-under for the tournament. Sean O'Hare of Pennsylvania carded a 7-under 65 on the Oaks and tied him for the lead at 7-under overall. The final day had some familiar names near the top of the leaderboard. The International's Kirk Hanifield nearly holed his tee shot on the par 3 13th. He'd finished the tournament 6th at 5-under par. The main focus of the tournament was on the last group, with Karbowski looking to claim back-to-back titles. He was paired with Telly Whiteman and Sean O'Hare. Jeff Sisk, who had an impressive showing at the difficult U.S. Open, would be the leader in the clubhouse as he carded a 7-under 65 on the final day, 9-under for the tournament. The last group was still jockeying for the lead, Sean O'Hare and Karbowski in a dogfight with the lead changing hands several times. But O'Hare's double bogey on the par 4 16th dashed any hopes of a championship. Whiteman holed this putt for birdie on the par 3 17th, putting him one shot back at 9-under for the tournament and forcing Karbowski to make this par putt to maintain a one-shot lead. Rick made it and strode to the 18th with a one-shot cushion. Whiteman was a little wayward off the tee on the par 5, 560-yard hole, while Karbowski placed his drive in the fairway. In the end, Karbowski showed his championship medal by hitting this fantastic bunker shot to 4 feet for an easy birdie, while Whiteman could only get par, giving Karbowski his second consecutive New England Open championship and the first prize check of $10,000. Rick will look to make it three in a row at the 2005 Sovereign Bank New England Open at the Lake Winnipesaukee Golf Club in September.